RC4 algorithm. RC4 algorithm is actually a stream cipher algorithm which is designed in 1987 by Ron Rivest for RSA security. Initially, it is a proprietary algorithm used by this RSA security. The RC name comes from Rivest cipher. RC means Rivest cipher version 4. This algorithm is actually a take variable key size. This stream cipher takes variable key size and it returns or ciphered in the form of byte. So it is called as a byte oriented operations here. It will take one byte from the plain text and convert into cipher byte. So RC4 algorithm works on byte. This algorithm is based on the use of random permutations. It is based on random permutations. I will explain this concept in the next part. Uses of RC4 algorithm. This RC4 algorithm is used in various applications, especially in the network, internet, especially in that area we are using. Now I have listed some of them. In the secure socket layer, transport layer security, that is called as SSL TLS standards that have been defined for communication between web browsers and servers. Whenever you are using communicating in web applications, we need SSL as well as TLS. In that we are using RC4 algorithm for streaming. In the wired equipment privacy, in wireless technology, we are using a protocol called as wired equipment privacy protocol. They are also used as RC4. One more wireless protocol we used called as Wi-Fi protected access, WPA version 1 it is. Wi-Fi protected access, WPA protocol, that are part of the IEEE 802.11 wireless LAN standard. In wireless protocol WAP, WPA, there also we are using RC4 algorithms. The RC4 algorithm is remarkably simple and quite easy to explain. First, I will explain how the RC4 algorithm works in brief. Later I will explain in detail how actually the process will be conducted by the RC4 algorithm. In RC4 algorithm, we are using variable length of key. The key size is not fixed here. One more, we need a state vector. We need here a state vector of size 256 bytes, which is actually ranging from 1 to 256 bytes here. And this state vector is initialized by this variable length key. At all times, this S contains a permutation of all the 8-bit numbers, which is ranging from 0 through 255. The state vector contains values between 0 to 255, but not in serial. It is in a permutation format, random format. For encryption and decryption, a byte K, that is key stream, is generated from S by selecting one of the 255 entries in a systematic fashion. As each value of K is generated, the entries in S are once again permuted. That means once the key stream is identified, one more time, the state vector is shuffled. Okay. So this is a process we done in the RC4 algorithm. I explain this concept in detail by using this diagram and some algorithm here. The first part is called as initialization of S here. First one is initialization of S. Here we have a state vector of size 256 bytes. Initially it is set with some values here, which is ranging from 0 to 255. That is, S0 is initialized to 0, S1 is initialized to 1, S2 is initialized to 2. Like that, it is initialized with values in ascending order. The last is actually 255. We are using one more vector here called as temporary vector T. Its size is also 256 bytes. This temporary vector is filled with key elements. Now, if the key length is 256 bytes, then we are just copy that key directly into T. All the elements of key is assigned with the T. If the key length is less than 256, then first we will copy that key into the temporary vector. Then some elements are here not initialized of the temporary vector. Again, that key is copied into the next free space or free element in the temporary vector. Again, it is copied into the next. That means this key is copied into the temporary vector in a repeated manner until all the elements of this temporary vector is filled with these key elements. The T contains the repeated key elements. In the next process, this is called as actually initialization state of S and T, which is explained by this algorithm here. I have started one loop here, which is starting from 0 to 255. Now this first statement just assign the value 0 to 255 to state vector, and this temporary vector is initialized with this key value, and this key value is repeated in the temporary vector. The next process is called as initial permutation of S. This diagram depicts the initial permutation of S. Here we are using T, that is temporary vector, to produce the initial permutation of the S. This actually starts from here, the first element, this is S0, and go through up to the last element, that is 255. For each element, that is SI, swapping the SI with another byte in the S according to scheme dictated by T of I. Here the swapping will be conducted. Here each element of the state vector is swapped with the another element of the state vector. So what is the meaning here is, initially the state vector contains the elements in ascending order 0 to 255. Now these elements are shuffled. Okay, that can be done by swapping two elements of the state vector. For that one, we are using the help of this temporary vector. That can be explained by this algorithm here. Initially see here, J is actually pointing to here 0, means whenever we are starting from SI, means S0, J is actually 0. For each increment here, J value is changing. Whenever you are doing some increment of I is incremented to 1, 2, 3, like that one. But the J value is continuously changing here. Now, the looping will take up to 255 elements, means 256 elements. Okay, now what is the j value here? J value is nothing but j plus s of I plus t of I. It will take the I element here, it will take the first element of I, first element of t, here it will take the first element of s and add it to the j value which is already there, and it will find out the position of the next element to be swapped. For example, if you go to here, I element here, t of I, s of I, it is added together. The added value is again added to the j value which is already having some value, previous value. If the total is larger than 256, it is, we have to use the modulus operator. We have to put the j value within 0 to 255. We have to put this value between 0 to 255, j value. So we have to use the modulus operator to keep it in 255. So I am using here modulus of 256. J value is within that range. Then I will change the j value with the I value. Here the swapping will be done for each and every element of the state vector. This is called as initial permutation of S. The next process is called as stream generation. Stream generation is used to generate the stream key. This step actually involves cycling through all the elements of Si, and for each Si, swapping Si with another byte in S according to the scheme dictated by the current configuration of S. Here, what happens for each element in this S, that is called as each element of this Si, is exchanged with the another element, and during this exchange element it will identify the position of the key stream. Once it reaches the process up to 255 elements, again the process continues here from the first element, that is S0. The finding of key is starting from the first element up to the last element. Once it reaches the last element, again it is reached back to first one. So it is cycling. Continuously it is cycling. Okay. Now how actually the process will be conducted, I will explain with this algorithm here. Now stream generation actually uses two variables here, I and j, which is initially 0 here. Now I is incremented in a ascending order one by one, that is 0, 1, 2, like that one. But j is incremented in random fashion. First time it may be pointing here, second time it may be pointing here. J's value is continuously changing here. Initially it is 0, but in a process it will change, because j value is actually depending on the value of the Si which is stored in this vector. Here I am using the while loop because this is a continuous process. We are using a stream here, stream of data. So this process will be continuous until there is no byte in the plain text. In the first case, we are just identifying the I value here. I am applying the modulus of 256. Because if the I value is increased more than 256, it is again pointing to the first element here. Again, it is starting from the first element. It is continuous. J value is actually random value, which is depending on the previous J value as well as the value of the value which is pointed by Si. If these two values are larger than 255, we have to use the modulus. The range of J should be within 0 to 255. Once you identify, for example, this one, okay, the Si value is this one. Okay, now I am identifying the Si value, this one. Now I am applying the j, calculating the j value here. J value is nothing but j plus Si, that is nothing but one more element in the S vector. Now these two elements I have to swap. I have to swap these two elements, that is done here. Once you done the swapping, I have to find out the total of that two numbers. That two numbers gives you the position of the key stream. So first I have to add these two values, these two elements I have to add. If the total is larger than 256, I have to apply some modulus operation here. I have to range within 0 to 255. So I have to apply some modulus operation here. Then I will identify the position of the key stream. So that is indicated by key here. Whatever the total you got by applying the modulus, that is the T value. The T value is nothing but the position of the key stream. Now I have to return this ST as the key stream. What I have to do next, whenever I want to apply some encryption, I want to XOR, a binary XOR operation I have to apply with one byte taken from the plain text to with the this key stream K. In similar way, in the decryption process, I have to apply the same XOR operation by taking this key stream K with one byte from the cipher text. So this will return back to the plain text. This is the working of our RC4 algorithm.